Hello and welcome to this assembly for Monday the 22nd of February 2021. As you can see, I'm doing things a little bit differently this week. First of all, I'm not outside, I'm in my office, and I hope to share a picture and a video with you today as well. It might not be as slick as I would like, but I hope that you will bear with me. The first thing I want to do is share this picture with you. It's something that's been in the news over the course of the last week. You might recognize it. It's the Mars rover. It's called Perseverance. Liftoff was last summer in July, so during the summer of 2020. And it landed on the surface of the red planet last week during your half term, so on the 18th of February. And we hope that it will bring back some important information that will help us understand our nearest planet a little bit better. But the reason I really want to talk to you about this today is because of the name of the Mars rover. As I said, it's called Perseverance. This name came about as a result of a competition that was launched in the USA, and which attracted 28,000 entries. The winning essay was from a seventh grade student. I think that's equivalent of somebody in year nine here. He was called Alexander Mather. He was from the state of Virginia. And in his essay, he mentioned the names of previous rovers: Curiosity, Sojourner, Spirit, and Opportunity. All names that could give us pause for thought, all names that we could unpack and explore a little bit further. However, he argued that one important thing was missing from this list. Something that encapsulated the fact that there would be setbacks in the quest to explore our nearest planet. And that was perseverance. He maintained that human beings were capable of adapting to any situation, no matter how difficult. And this obviously struck a chord with NASA scientists. They'd had to overcome a number of obstacles, including funding cuts over the last decade as they worked on this mission. So just what do we mean by perseverance? Well, it's about keeping going with something, persisting in a task, not giving up. It's about stickability, not just starting something, but also finishing it, and finishing it well. It suggests something that's inherently difficult. There's always the sense that it would be easier not to bother or to give up altogether. But here's the thing, it's always worth persevering, and we can't achieve anything worthwhile unless we're prepared to commit. If you look at anyone who's achieved greatness in a particular field, they've done so by persevering. They've taken knocks along the way, but they've got up again, and they've kept going until they've succeeded in what they set out to do. Another thing to know about perseverance is that it brings its rewards. You might have seen this in your own achievements, for example, in your subjects, or perhaps in music or in sport, but they don't have to be big things either. I enjoy cycling. One of the toughest things in cycling is cycling into a headwind. But if you keep going, when you turn around and start heading in the opposite direction, the wind will push you along. It suddenly seems easy and you really enjoy what you're doing. In other words, it's really worth the effort. But I'm going to share with you something that's perhaps a little bit more inspirational than that. It's a video from the BBC, and it features one of our past pupils, he's called Al Menny, and he talks a little bit about a challenge that he set himself and how he has to persevere with that. It only lasts a minute or so, so please have a look and see what he has to say.
Like, you can see behind me here, there's snow on the beach tonight. I'm still doing this. It's just a great thing to be outside. It's so good for your mental health to be outside as often as possible. I am swimming 100 kilometers in total in the surf off the north coast here, and we're in Northern Ireland, in the darkest, coldest months of the winter. I've got a long history connected to the sea. I've talked decades of being a surfer, in particular on this beach. And as soon as the lights go out, it's dark. It's a different world, it's a different thing altogether. And, you know, there's no, although I've got all this experience, it doesn't predict the unknown, it doesn't predict what's out there in the dark. You know, it's a perfect metaphor for life. I'm out in the dark dealing with waves I can't see coming, currents I can't see coming, yet I have to persevere through it. Every night get through that little swim to, you know, chip away at the total. But don't, if you're watching this, don't go out and swim in the dark, just go for water.
So that's Al Menny. But I think we all need to persevere at the moment. Perseverance is something we need to nurture as we face an extension to school closure and to an extension to our COVID restrictions. Psychologically, where it might have been possible to keep going over a six-week period, the longer this continues, the more difficult it becomes for everyone. It requires fortitude, determination, and mental strength. And also, I think, encouragement from other people. So maybe as we take a short silence now, you can think about how you can persevere in things that you've set out to do and how you can help others to do the same. Well, thanks again for tuning in. I hope everyone has had a good half term, and I hope as well that you're feeling refreshed after the break. As you know, we've had a bit of a setback in terms of our return to school, which means that we won't be seeing anybody until the 22nd of March. And even then, that will only be pupils from years 12 to 14. Those in years 8 to 11 probably won't be returning until after Easter, but we will keep you posted on that. We'll be continuing with remote learning for the time being, and your teachers will give you more details about what's happening there. That's all from me for today. Have a good week.